You have redeemed us, Lord, by your blood from every tribe and time and people and nation. And have made us a new kingdom of priests for our God, among your own. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Let's see a way of God's grace. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you fill us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, restore us to eternal life and the resurrection of Christ. Raise us up, we pray, to the author of our salvation, who is seated at your right hand, so that when our Savior comes again in majesty, those who have given new birth and baptism may be clothed with blessed immortality. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. One night when Paul was in Corinth, the Lord said to him in a vision, "Do not be afraid. Go on speaking and do not be silent, for I am with you. No one will attack or harm you, for I have many people in this city." He settled there for a year and a half and taught the word of God among them. But when Galileo was proconsul of Achaia, the Jews rose up together against Paul and brought him to the tribunal, saying, "This man is inducing people to worship God contrary to the law." When Paul was about to reply, Galileo spoke to the Jews, "If it were a matter of some crime or malicious fraud, I should refuse to hear the complaint of you Jews. But since it is a question of arguments over doctrine and titles and your own law, see to it yourselves. I do not wish to be the judge of such matters." He drove them away from the tribunal. They all seized Sophanes, the synagogue official, and beat him in full view of the tribunal. But none of this was a concern to Galileo. Paul remained for quite some time, and after saying farewell to the brothers, he sailed for Syria, together with Priscilla and Aquila. At Chenchari, he had shaved his head, because he had taken a vow. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God is King of all the earth. God is King of all the earth. All you people, slap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High and Awesome, is the great King over all the earth.
God is King of all the earth.
He brings people under us, nations under our feet. He chooses for us our inheritance, the glory of Jacob, whom he loves.
God is the King of all the earth.
God bounces through with shouts of joy, the Lord in a trumpet blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God is the King of all the earth.
And the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn, all the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will become joy. When a woman is in labor, she is in anguish because her hour has arrived. But when she has given birth to a child, she no longer remembers the pain because of her joy, for the child is no more into the world. So you also are now in anguish, but I will see you again and your hearts will rejoice. No one will take your joy away from you. On that day you will not question me about anything. Amen, amen, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Grief of the disciples is the departure of Jesus, which is in the his ascending into heaven. So he ascends to heaven and leaves them, and now they themselves have to make about what they are supposed to be doing in behalf of Christ. And it's in that sense, they're left in an unknown manner of life. In other words, like to be in a position where we don't know what to do. We like to take control of what's happening around us. And somehow, when Jesus leaves them, they don't have the control anymore. Now they have to kind of muddle their way through as how Christ is. And what Christ promises them is they're not alone. The Advocate is sent. Holy Spirit will serve. Choice they need to make. He will also return somehow with his grace, his fullness, his riches. But the departure is nothing more than a sense of helping them grow up. That's all of us. We all have to grow up as our second parent. Parent takes care of all your needs, and now the child moves on, and now they have to do it themselves. And there's fear in that, there's anxiety, there's worry. And by simply walking with faith and trust that we have the capabilities, my parents gave me what I needed, God's given me what I needed in faith. Somehow when we do it on our own, then we ourselves grow in the midst of our faith. And so Jesus' departure is nothing more than us growing up and acting upon his grace and goodness in a new way. And so today let's try to find ways to do that. Ways in a sense to express it. The growing up attitude, growing up way of knowing I need to express the faith in my own manner, in my own self. And in doing so, somehow find the fullness of riches that God desires. And that joy, once again, which I knew back as a child, becomes a new reality as an adult. We ask God for that grace. We bring our needs to God. That the Lord may heal the wounds of his church and bring justice and healing to her members, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace of Christ may overpower nations in conflict, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may relieve the suffering of all who struggle with disease or ill health, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ may bring consolation to those in our communities who are mourning the loss of loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may experience eternal life with Christ and the glory of the resurrection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bring our own needs to God. And for these needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of wonder and light, we bring these prayers before you. Hear them and answer them through Christ our Lord. Blessed be you, Lord, out of all creation, with your good service, bread we offer to you, fruit of the earth, work with human hands, and become for us our life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you, Lord, out of all creation, with your good service, wine we offer to you, fruit of the fire, work with human hands, and become for us our spiritual dream. Holy, holy, holy. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the least gifts we pray, send that your Spirit come and let the dew fall, that they may come for us, body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the sacraments of trade, in your will and in your expansion, took prayer, giving thanks for it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all in your hand, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when someone was in and took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give me thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that we take in the body and blood of Christ and we gather in the one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring it in the fullness of charity, and gather with Francis, our Pope, Gerald, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember, our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, and the blessed apostles, and all the saints of Asia throughout the ages. We may merit to be the heirs of eternal life, and the praise and glorify you. Your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command informed my life teaching me dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray for your people, gracious and grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, may you always free from sin and save from all distress. As we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, we say you might be saved. God, our sin on the faith of the church, be gracious to God, peace and unity in accordance with your will, and live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
And may give peace to your families, and peace to high, peace to others. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof,
but only say the word of my soul.
Thank you. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, and redeem